السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، معكم دكتور حيدر سعد القاسم، استشاري باطنية، ميديكال اونكولوجيست، كلية طب ميسان، جامعة ميسان. محاضرتنا اليوم حول البليدنج ديس اوردر، المرحلة الخامسة. To start with bleeding disorder, we have normal and abnormal pathology regarding the blood vessels and platelet. You know, laboratory test essential for assessment of bleeding disorder depends on bleeding time, which depends on platelet count, and we need tests for coagulations like PT and PTT, which give us idea about clotting factor, which are all synthesized by the liver. Normally, the vascular wall having both properties, both antithrombotic and prothrombotic properties, and this keep our blood in a balanced state. Platelet is the major player for bleeding disorder, and you know platelet adhesion needs von Willebrand factor, which is clotting factor synthesized by the endothelial surface of the blood vessels, and need platelet receptors to attach with, and these receptors called glycoprotein 2B and 3A. Coagulation pathway, we have both intrinsic and extrinsic pathway, and both of them end with common or final pathway, which lead to thrombus formation. Control of coagulation, we need antithrombin 3, protein C and S, which are essential for clot lysis. Fibrinolytic cascades depend on plasminogen, which convert plasmin to FDB, fibrinogen degradation product, and D-dimer, which is most important end product of FDP. The first step in evaluating patients suspected with bleeding disorders is confirm that disorder. So we start with thorough history that includes medical conditions, any spontaneous bleeding, family history, very essential, and medication history. The history also helps determine if the disorder is likely to be inherited or acquired, and likely due to platelet, vascular, or coagulation abnormalities. These are list of drugs that can cause bleeding disorders. The most important groups of drugs are anticoagulant, antiplatelet, NSAIDs, steroid, antibiotics, antidepressant, alcohol, vitamin E, and even garlic. Bleeding disorder, we have either vascular abnormalities, platelet disorder, clotting abnormalities, or DIC. We'll discuss the first two abnormalities. Vascular abnormalities, the major cause of bleeding is infection. The most common cause of infection is meningococcal meningitis, which end with meningococcemia, rickettsial disease, infective endocarditis, drug reactions, hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia, which is associated with hemoptysis, and skin subcutaneous bleeding, which is autosomal dominant, Cushing syndrome, Henoch-Schönlein purpura, which is mainly in pediatric age group, and adolescent, characterized by skin rash, vasculitic rash, abdominal pain, and could be bleeding per rectum with renal affection. Scurvy, which is caused by vitamin C deficiency, Ehlers-Danlos, connective tissue disorders, amyloid infiltration, which mainly caused by multiple myeloma. Let us talk about platelet disorders, which is the main cause of bleeding disorders. We have either decreased production, like bone marrow failure or hypersenilism, or increased destruction, like primary idiopathic immune thrombocytopenia. Thrombocytopenia means platelet count below normal, and usually it is below 100, causes either decreased production of platelet, like vitamin B12, folic acid deficiency, decreased platelet survival, immunological cause, ITB at the top of the list, sequestration, hypersenilism, especially seen in patient chronic liver disease, and dilutional followed massive transfusion. ITB causes, these are antibodies directed against platelet membrane glycoprotein complex 2B3A mainly. Peripheral blood film show thrombocytopenia and a platelet count, as I said, below 100,000, abnormal large platelets, megakaryocyte, which are giant platelets, which is immature platelet, and usually seen by increase in platelet distribution, which are seen by automated blood count, more usually normal or increased megakaryocyte. Diagnosis is by exclusion, bleeding time prolonged, but BT and PTT was normal. It's a disease of young age group, pediatric age group, mainly in male, and elderly, it is mainly in female. Clinical feature depends on platelet count, but the platelet count variable from person to person. I mean, what the patient could have a platelet count of 60 and have a bleeding, and the patient, other patient have platelet count of 20 and have no bleeding. Additional test, we need to test for H. pylori test associated with ITB, thyroid function test as autoimmune disease, bone marrow examination for elderly patient to exclude myelodysplastic syndrome, unfiltered bone disease, neurological studies, mainly connective tissue disease at the top of the list, systemic lupus, erythematosus, folate and B12 deficiency, antiplatelet antibody usually not done in routine investigation. Patient with bleeding out of proportion to the degree of thrombocytopenia may warrant evaluation for type 2B von Willebrand disease or Bernard-Soiler syndrome. I mean, patient with platelet count, let us say 80 and have severe bleeding, do not correlate with this platelet count. You should exclude type 2 von Willebrand disease. For patient, as the guideline said, the platelet count below 30, he needed treatment. Above 30, no clinical bleeding, he is not in need for a treatment. And drug of choice, as you know, steroid number one, IVIG number two, and platelet transfusion. We suggest non-specific treatment or no treatment in patient with platelet count more than 30 without any bleeding, clinical bleeding, obvious bleeding. And for those patient with risk of infection with encapsulated microorganism, and we are planning for splenectomy, or we are planning for giving rituximab, monoclonal antibody against B lymphocyte CD20 marker, we should give antibiotic prophylaxis. This is a very important diagram. Diagnose ITB, platelet count below, above 30, observation only. Below 30, steroid, drug of choice. There is contraindication of steroid, or if we need rapid action, we can give IVIG, intravenous immunoglobulin. If after that platelet count above 20, so observation only, below 20, splenectomy, rituximab, or thromboboetine, which is receptor agonist for the platelet. If it is more than 20 observation, less than 20, other modalities of treatment. NTD also can be used, and is effective only in patient with Rh positive. It is not effective in patient with splenectomy. For patients who require rapid treatment, as I said, we need IVIG. Exception, those patients not tolerate steroid, we can use IVIG as initial treatment. But the problem with IVIG is the cost. For most patients, this is a very important statement, treatment with steroid, we suggest short course of high-dose oral dexamethasone, 40 milligram for 5 days. And we stop it, then we can repeat this cycle every 2 weeks for up to 6 cycles. And by this, we avoid pituitary adrenal suppression and no need for tapering. What about HIT, heparin-induced thrombocytopenia? Could be early, could be late, early within 5 days, late after 7 days. So we need to assess platelet count daily for patient taking heparin. And the treatment is, of course, stop heparin and replace it by another anticoagulant drugs. What about HIV? As you know, platelet or megakaryocyte carrying CD4 receptor, so it is a target for HIV. TTB, HUS, very important topics to be talked about because they are causing high mortality rate. They are caused by hyaline platelet thrombi in the microcirculation and pathogenesis, systemic endothelial cell damage. Fever, main presentation, thrombocytopenia, renal impairment, hemolytic anemia with evidence of hemolysis as seen by elevated bilirubin, mainly indirect, elevated platelet count, lactic dehydrogenase elevated, haptoglobinin low, and can be differentiated from DIC by normal PT and PTT. And these are the tests used to confirm TTB or HUS, and the last test is very important, ADAMS-13 activity and inhibitor test. It's essential for the pathogenesis of the disease. And we have a score here, calculator, plasmic score. When we have no ADAMS-13 assessment, and this score, if it is more than 7, high risk patient for TTB. And as I mentioned, the treatment is plasma exchange, which is very essential and curative treatment. Congenital platelet disorder, we have giant platelet. What we mean by platelet disorder, we have normal platelet count, but abnormal platelet function. The most common cause is Bernard-Soiler and Glanzmann thrombocythemia. Treatment, usually they give them platelet transfusion if not responding, factor 7, activated factor 7, or bone marrow transplantation. And I think we can stop here, and let us discuss clotting factor abnormalities and DIC in another session. I hope you are enjoying with such a rapid talk about bleeding disorder. Please, if you have any question or comment, you can contact us with this email. And thank you very much.